Hello, welcome to Travel with Suri. If you are looking for an enchanting seaside vacation getaway to cure your stressed out life, put this island at the top. The nautical ambience and small town simplicity of the island will charm you into a carefree state of mind in no time. Plant your chair and umbrella on the best beach in America. Pristine white sand beaches, unbelievable shopping, and a touch of historical magic will make this vacation one to remember. Welcome to Coronado Island, San Diego, California. In 1969, the San Diego-Coronado Bay Bridge was completed and made Coronado Island much more accessible. There were several proposals over the years to build a bridge, but it was not until 1964 that the bridge was approved by the Pentagon. After a groundbreaking in 1967 and 2 years of construction, opening ceremonies were held on August 1969 and included a parade of vintage cars. This spectacular bridge is a beautiful sparkling blue and more than 2 miles in length, with a visually dramatic 90-degree shift at midpoint. Coronado Island is located across the bay from San Diego and has an extremely interesting history. To start, it is not actually an island but a peninsula, since it is connected to the mainland by a narrow stretch of land. A beautiful, spectacular, and stunning skyline of San Diego. Very, very beautiful. The striking architectural design of Coronado Ferry Landing is reminiscent of the famous Hotel Del Coronado. It is home to a sensational restaurant row made up of 7 bayfront fine and casual dining. If you like to dine and shop, this is the place to be. There are also several excellent shops and galleries offering unique gifts, collectibles, imported fashions, beachwear, and much more. The Coronado Ferry Landing has some small shops, a few places to eat, you can get your coffee or ride the ferry. Yeah, it's a nice place. Many visitors choose to take a biking tour of Orange Avenue because of its aesthetic appeal and ocean breezes. The city of Coronado is known for its spectacular bridge, historical resort, and perfect weather. However, Coronado also offers a unique shopping experience along Orange Avenue, located just north of the famous Hotel Del Coronado. Orange Avenue is lined with many shops with boutiques, antiques, and jewelry that are one of a kind. As visitors stroll the palm-lined avenue, they will be surprised to discover shops they have never seen or heard of before. Each storefront displays a unique combination of goods, so even window shopping is a satisfying activity. Parking is sometimes difficult along the avenue itself, but this allows visitors to take even more time to discover the island. Now let's get into some history. Coronado was discovered by Sebastian Vizcaino, a Spanish explorer in 1602. He named the islands Los Coronados. Vizcaino also quite literally put Coronado on the map, creating a map of San Diego Bay Area when he was there and permanently etching Coronado into history. After Sebastian Vizcaino named and mapped Coronado Island, Europeans would not visit the island for over another 100 years. Eventually, in 1885, Elisha and Hampton Story and their partners purchased Coronado Island with the intent to turn it into a resort town. Up until this point, Coronado was largely uninhabited by people, and its largest population was the extremely high number of jackrabbits that lived there. In 1888, the Hotel Del Coronado opened its doors for the first time, marking Coronado's official entry into the world tourism. Coronado Beach was ranked the best beach in the United States based on the beach environmental quality, safety for swimmers, the feel of the sand, water quality, amenities, crowds, and weather. While you are on the beach, make sure to take time to visit one of the most iconic buildings in all of California, the Hotel Del Coronado. The living legend's 130-year history weaves stories of dignitaries, celebrities, and even royalty on the path to becoming a National Historic Landmark. When it opened in 1888, it was the single largest resort hotel in the world. It has hosted presidents, royalty, and celebrities through the years. The hotel has been featured in numerous movies and books. Blue Water Boathouse is one of the best seafood restaurant in Coronado Island. Enjoy a waterfront patio in a historic site, full bar, happy hour, a hyper local menu and private event rooms. I'm just sitting here. I got time. It's clear to see. From up here. Winning awards all around the country for the best beach, the Coronado shoreline takes priority when visiting the island. The mile and a half stretch of Golden Beach actually sparkles thanks to small pieces of mica embedded in the sand. We meant to be in the great outdoors forever. I liked all these luxurious oceanfront homes. This is Centennial Park, just walkable distance from Coronado Ferry Landing. This is the best place to take picture of San Diego skyline. The Coronado Ferry connects downtown San Diego to Coronado Island. A great way to get to San Diego and back without the hassles of bridge or freeway traffic. One-way ticket is $5 and round-trip ticket is $10. You can take your cycle for free of cost. There are two places you can catch the ferry to Coronado Island. One starts at Broadway Pier and another one starts at San Diego Convention Center. It is just a 15-minute crossing and a popular activity for tourists in downtown San Diego. The view of San Diego skyline is most frequently photographed from this park. So if you are in San Diego or Southern California, I would highly recommend going to this island. This is really beautiful island and you will love it. I hope you all liked my video. If you like it, please subscribe it. Thank you so much for watching.